Rectifier is the device which converts AC voltage or current into DC voltage or current. The need of rectifier, and rectifier is mostly used in DC power supply. Some applications like DC power supplies, battery chargers, mobile chargers, etc. This is the circuit of half wave rectifier. PN junction diode. Load resistance RL. Step down transformer connected to 230 volt AC supply. For example, this is the input for rectifier, which is AC waveform, which changes its polarity with respect to time. The output of rectifier due to forward bias of diode, it will give output for the positive half cycle, whereas for negative half cycle, it will not give the output because diode is in reverse bias. Now, practical of half-wave rectifier of the breadboard. It requires PN junction diode, resistance, center tap transformer. Identify the cathode of PN junction diode, which is marked by silver ring on the heat. Now, take the resistance. Now tie resistance and diode together to form a half-wave rectifier. Now connect the one wire of transformer to the anode of PN junction diode. And second wire of transformer to the resistor. And this is the final circuit of half wave rectifier. Now checking the waveforms on the CRO. First, we will observe the input for half-wave rectifier, that is out, that is the secondary waveform across the transformer. This is the input for half-wave rectifier and this is the output of half-wave rectifier. We have made this circuit without using the breadboard. Next is full wave rectifier of the breadboard. Circuit for the full wave rectifier. We are designing full wave rectifier with center tap transformer. This is the very simple circuit of full wave rectifier, which uses 2-PN junction diode. The basic difference between full wave rectifier and half wave rectifier is number of diodes and center tap transformer required. The output of rectifier in first case, diode D1 will forward bias and D2 will reverse bias, hence this is the output due to diode D1. Now for negative half cycle, diode D2 will conduct and D1 remains reverse bias. For again positive half cycle, D1 is forward bias and D2 is reverse biased. Center tap transformer. Why it is called as center tap transformer? Let's check. Across the secondary, it is showing 30 volt, whereas center tap showing 15 volt. Now for the circuit of full wave rectifier, full wave center tap rectifier, take two diodes, identify the cathode of diode. Take two diodes and one load resistance, tie them together. And this is the center tap full wave rectifier. Now connect anode of one diode to the one terminal of transformer and second to the second terminal of transformer. Connect the common terminal of transformer to the load resistance. Now the circuit is ready to the test. Turn on the CRO. Most of the time student will connect the CRO probe in reverse manner. What will happen? Let's check. it will give the output in reverse direction. And this is the output of full wave rectifier circuit.